So first of all, you were waiting for this fight. It's here. Last time I saw you, you were in Dallas, Texas on the bus. And look at you now. How you been? What a roller coaster of a career.
Yeah, it's fun. It's been fun. It was, you know, the career's going up, down, but it's been great all together. You know, a lot of those losses I had was a great learning experience for me. And, you know, I learned a lot, you know, with those types of fights. And I learned a lot how to appreciate what you have as a world champion and not to take it for granted. And, you know, this type of fight, I mean, it's a big test for me. You know, another world champion. A lot of fighters don't do that nowadays. You know, they don't go up against the world champions. But I want to test myself and see, you know, where I am at this stage of my career. And for me, you know, all of that happened in the past is just all factored into what is going to happen on November 17th. So hopefully it's going to come out as a win. So in terms of having to readjust your schedule again, as far as this training schedule, try not to peak at the wrong time. Not to try to get too stale when it comes down to training and when you're in the gym. So, you know, there's a few times where I had to take a break here and there. You know, with any fighter, you know, when you prepare mentally that you're going to be ready for a certain date, and then you find out last minute that it's going to be pushed back, you know, frustrates you. But then it happened so much in my career that I kind of almost expected it already, and I learned how to adjust to that type of situation. So you know, it happened in the Solis fight, it happened in the Segura fight, now it happened in Marquez fight, but it gives you an extra time, you know, for you to adjust on things that you need to adjust on, especially training in your style. So I think it helped out a little bit more. So now that November 17th is happening, you know, let's get our nose to the grinder and keep training hard.
How many breaks did you take when you first started training for the fight?
I took a couple, but you know what? During those training, during those breaks, I did still train, so it really wasn't much of a break. I kept myself in shape, kept my weight close to my fight weight, so I didn't get too overblown and I didn't really get too crazy. You know, as far as that, I don't drink alcohol anyway, and I don't party too hard. I don't stay out late, so I just, you know, keep myself focused at the right time. Even on the little breaks, I kept myself busy.
How do you maintain your weight? Because last time you told me you have a lock on your refrigerator. Is that true?
Not anymore. I mean, I think I've got myself responsible enough to.
But look at you. You're in shape.
Yeah. You know, I'm great. I feel great. You know, I feel good. I know how important it is, you know, especially at this stage of my career, you know, that every fight is going to be an important fight for me. And I don't want to feel what I felt against the Carlos Tamara fight again. And I just want to come back up. I've been putting a great string of great wins. Now I just want to continue that, you know, and it starts off with how you live. You know, it's a lifestyle for you to stay in shape. It's a lifestyle for you to eat and train every day. We don't have seasons in boxing, you know. Every fight, you know, is gonna come out there, you know, like baseball or basketball, and people can take off. We can't do that in boxing. Even when you don't have a fight, you're gonna have to still stay in shape.